All right, hey guys, here we are again today. We are going to draw Bruni from Frozen 2, but we are going to give it about a minute or two to let other people jump on. The colors you're going to need today are two different blues, right? A lighter blue and a darker blue. A bright pink or magenta color, and as always, our standard Sharpie black. Today is National Autism Awareness Day. Got my bracelet on. Give it almost one more minute here, and then we're gonna go ahead and get started. All right, let's go ahead and get started. So, Bruni from Frozen 2. I'm gonna make an oval. There, and then from that oval, he's just going to drop two lines down. That's going to be his neck. This one can come straight down, bring it all the way down past. Okay. We're just going to do some basic shapes for his body. Alright, so I'm going to put a little oval here, alright. Then we're going to put a little circle here. Tail's going to be. Just bring it down. All right. And then for his feet, his legs and feet, I'm just going to put like a little stump right there. Okay. Give my camera a second to catch up. There we go. And then another. And put another stump right there. Make sure it comes down a little bit lower than the first one you did. Put another one right here. That's going to go a little higher. So if that's your floor line, higher, higher. This is the back one. He's pushing towards the front, so this one's a little bit farther away. Okay. All right. So now we're going to go back and we're just going to add a little point right there, right there. Okay. Make sure it comes just past that circle. You can bring it down. Same thing on this side. Bring it down. And then just curve transition into that neck. Alright. Down here. And trace this line down. And bring it right into that bottom oval. Okay. And now for his back here, I'm just going to make a little curve right there off his neck. See, come down where your oval is and where your neckline is. You're just going to make a curve transition right there. And you're going to follow it down, okay? Where that and transition smooth over to where that circle is, and then bring it down into the tail. So you want like a little bump right there, okay? So now, we'll go into his legs. Just above where the lower body line is, come just above there. Then make a straight line down. Alright. Keep your floor line in mind right there. And then on the back of his leg, you're going to come up higher and more in, more to the right, and just curve it down. In a little bit. Okay. Right here, you can just make a couple little circles. Right there. And then point them out. Just like that. And then one in the back. Okay. Now we'll do this leg. Same thing. Just gonna make a little darker round line there. Right. Put that little point. And then come out here to a point. Now see where the point is? It's right on that little stump line that we did right there. Now just above that, you're going to make another little point. And just connect it. Okay. Now we're going to come do his underbelly and his back leg. So on that oval that you did, you can just draw a little line right there and then cut it over to that stump. See? It kind of comes down right there. I'm going to line down. And again, down to that same point like we did on the other feet. A gonna put another little point right there. Right? And another one. Push this one out to the side a little bit. A little separation. And then one more behind that. Right? And then we're gonna come up here to where this oval that you made originally. Right, you're gonna come up to that line and just come back nice and round. Okay. All right. And now the tail. Hey Bobby, I see you there. This is kind of a reptile. This is Bruni from Frozen 2. So, alright, so let's finish up his head. Alright. So we're bringing that, we have that line there. And we have this line in here. So we're just going to put a couple little arrows right there. Alright. See that? And then we're going to come up a little bit. A couple little humps right there. Right. Same thing on this side. Come up. Bring it down. Now, I'm going to put his mouth in. Before we do the eyes, we'll put his mouth in. So just above those two points that we put here, I'm just going to make a little line. A little line. And then come down and curve it in. Same over here. Come down, curve it in, and then you're just going to make a little wave. Okay. Look, he's got a little smile there. All right. Now we're going to put his eyes in. Now his eyes don't go all the way up here. They stay down here. Right. And we got one. And we'll come over here. They're kind of more round on the outside than they are on the inside. Okay. Put his nostrils in. And then we'll put this pupils in his eyes. Okay. This is Disney drawing at its best. Now he's got a little diamond on his back here. And we're just gonna do like that. because you don't really see it all, you just see the point. There we go. So now we'll add a couple little more details here. So I'm gonna put a couple lines in his feet and his toes. Same over here. Just go through and put those lines in any way you want. It's just to make it look like he has toes. He's got a couple stripes on his leg. Little tiger stripes on his legs. I'll put those in. One over here on this foot. There. So now you're going to need. That's basically all our pencil. Alright. So now, you're going to need two different color blue, and then like a hot pink or a magenta color, and of course our standard Sharpie. I said that in the beginning, but I don't think there's anybody on when I said it the first time, so I'll repeat it. So now we'll go through with our Sharpie. Oh, you know what? I did forget one thing here. Right off of this foot, and a line that comes off his neck right here. Have to kind of come down and curve that right to the bottom of, or the top of his leg there. Alright. Now we're going to do the same thing right here. It's just his underside. And that'll be that lighter color blue. Now we can go to ink. So I'm actually going to use two different Sharpie markers because he has some real thick lines, but then he has some real thin lines too. That way his eyes don't look all washed out while we're doing it. Now I'm going to switch it with that thinner Sharpie. Forget your little points here. Yep. There. How are we doing out there, guys? Say, don't be afraid to turn the paper any way you need to. Forget those little lines you put them toes to. I can always tell when it's a decent day out because I don't have as many people on here. That's all right. Here. That's just where the joint of his leg is. Now we can go back and erase all those pencil lines. Okay. So two different blues. This is actually a watercolor brush, but it's a really nice color. Use that as the main part of his body. Those stripes on his legs are just a little bit darker than all the other colors, so I'm going to let those alone right now. And then once this ink is dry on it, I can go back and I can add more color, darken up those lines. I've learned with the watercolors, you have to make sure that you always go in the straight line in the same direction that you're coloring, because if not, it will really look like a mess. So we try and stay in the same direction. You can see that this marker is not as smooth as the other ones I use. I just didn't have quite the right color, I felt, for this guy in my alcohol markers. So I just figured I'll use the watercolor marker. It's not as clean, but the color's nice. Under his mouth, all this is going to be a different color, so don't color that part in. So I got a request for a chipmunk. What kind of chipmunk are we talking about? A real one or a cartoony one? Stop with that one. Let me get that magenta color, that pink color out. And just color these little spots right here in. And then that diamond on his back gets that same color. Now, I'm going to go with that other blue, and we're going to on the camera it probably doesn't look much different, but it is. Right. putting this over top, this other marker, just to try and get a little darker color. If you wanted to, you could go back and, put some ground lines in. Ice. Not all of it's in ice. There are some nice little wooded spots, so you can put a couple little green lines in there. Frozen 2. Alright guys, hope you had a good time. I did too. Remember, tonight at 7 o'clock, we're going to be making a sensory bottle. So right there, that's what we'll be making. This, oddly enough, is a Frozen 2, or a Frozen bottle. If you look inside, you can see all the snowflakes in there. All right. You don't need to have a bottle like this. If you have a mason jar, mayonnaise jar, small water bottle, anything, All right. So we'll be doing that tonight, 7 o'clock. And I will see all of you then. All right. Have a great afternoon. See you tonight. Thanks for drawing with me. And bye-bye.